Hi, welcome back. Today I will be reviewing the Pilot Cutlass. It is a very nice pen and it has some very special features to it and it deserves a review in my opinion. So let's see inside. The Pilot Cutlass comes inside various kinds of boxes. This is the box where I got one, maybe not this one, but it is possible to come in a box like this. It is a plastic box, has a cardboard outer box, then this hard plastic box, nothing special with the Pilot logo there. And we open it, it says Pilot. It has the warranty card, leaflet, and it comes with one or two cartridges, and the pen comes with a converter inside, and here we have the pen. So let's take a look at this pen is the Pilot Cutlass, but with the finish that is called Blue Carbonesque. So let's talk a little bit about it first, just to clarify some things. This pen is called Pilot Cutlass, at least in Europe. In the United States, it is called Namiki Vanishing Point. The pen is the same. It's just some branding option for the United States and for Europe. This finish is called Blue Carbonesque. Or Kazuri. It is called carbonesque because it reminds us of the carbon fiber, but this is not carbon fiber. But it has this kind of texture, quite nice. This comes in several colors, and that's it. This is the kind of pen that I really like, so that is why I have this one. This one is the first time reviewing in our YouTube channel, but and because it was the first one I got. However, I have another four. And here they are by order of appearance in my collection. This was the first, the Blue Carbonesque, then it was the mustard yellow, then came the matte black, which is quite nice. Then I got this vintage one. I can't remember by heart the name of the model, but it is a Pilot Cutlass and then it has a specific model. I can't remember now. But it is a vintage one, and then the last one I got, which is quite nice, which is the green Carbonesque or the green Kazuri, or even the graphite green. It is also called that way. So this is a kind of pen that I really like. I will show you why, and that is why, because I love them, I got five of them. So, let's see what I have to say about this pen. So, first of all, what is the most specific feature of this pen? It is the fact of it being capless. So, it means it has no cap to remove to be able to write with it. This pen just has a clicking mechanism and it has a retractable nib that comes inside and out as we need to use it. Quite easy, you can have these operated with a single hand. It is very useful for meetings and just to put down some notes. Very easy to use. Because of the clicking mechanism. You don't have to worry with the cap and screwing back the cap. But it may have some problems for some people. Because the nib is here on this end of the pen. There's some ink there. Because the nib is here, and because you need to sit the pen in your pocket upright, it means you have the clip next to the nib, and you have to hold the pen like this. It is a well-known problem for many users because they don't get used to have a clip between their fingers, but the clip even has a groove here to give you the right place to put your fingers. For me, there is no problem about it. I really like that. There is no trouble to hold the pen like this, and I find it very comfortable to use. We have to see that this pen is long enough to write with, very comfortable. It has a nice weight, it's not super heavy, but it is made of metal, and it is thick enough for big hands. I'll just show it to you next to a Parker do Fold Centennial size. So as you can see, it is even a little bit longer than the Parker Centennial do Fold. It is less thick in the barrel, but it is thicker where you grip the pen because this is a little slender than this. And when you have this cap, the pen ready to write, it really is longer than the do fold because of the So we have this size comparison. So let's look a little better at the pen. The pen has this button that activates the nib, as I showed you. Then it has this pattern all around it. It has a double ring, metal ring. This is silver colored one in this pen, but in others it may be gold or black. And it has this pattern all over the barrel. Here you have the printing of Pilot Japan. You can see here quite well this pattern, which is nice and has a very nice reflection. And then you have this, let's call it section, with the clip, and it's quite simple. When you will look at the top of the pen, I don't think I can show you, there is a cap there that comes down when the nib comes out. I don't think I'll be able to show you because of the light, but what happens is this has some kind of a trapdoor that closes and seals the pen for the nib to not dry. And when you activate the nib, this door comes down and the nib comes out. It is the internal mechanism that pushes the door. It's not the nib that forces the door that would be able to damage the nib. So here we have the pen. It's just that when we activate the nib, you can see it is a very small nib with a breather hole, but very, very small. And that's it. The pen inside, to see how it is and how it works, you have to unscrew this, as you have to do with everything that has a spring. Just keep your hand there to avoid this part to fly somewhere. This pen can take cartridge or converter. Now it has a cartridge, and to use with a cartridge, it comes with this metal sleeve, and this metal sleeve is just to give some rigidity to the usual Pilot cartridge. Because it is a softer plastic, it can deform when you add the pressure of the spring. So with this, There is no trouble because this protects and gives it more stiffness. Then you have the nib. I'll try to show you the nib closely. It says Pilot 18K and it is a fine nib. This is a gold nib, 18 karat gold nib, and it has a rhodium plating that makes it silver colored. Very nice nib. I like Pilot nibs, so it's very consistent. More about this pen. It's it. You can use it very easily. You shouldn't disassemble this pen more than these because it has a complicated mechanism inside. It's not meant to be taken apart. And also this nib is... This is a very thin feed. I wouldn't try to remove this nib outside of the nib unit. You can buy these nib units separately if you need. The pen costs around 150 euros. It depends on the kind of finish. This is not the cheapest, but not the most expensive. So here you have a very nice color, a very nice pen. I really like it. And let's just see how the pen writes. So let's see. The paper is the Euro. The Rhodia dot pet. The pen is the Pilot Capless Blue Carbonesque with a fine nib. And the ink, I think, is Montegrappa Brown. So, first of all, you may notice some noise when the nib goes onto the paper. This pen is not scratchy, not at all. The Pilot nibs are very, very good. They are, I have to say, they are flawless. I love Pilot nibs. They just have a little of feedback. They are smooth, very smooth, but not that kind of smoothness that you don't feel the paper. You feel the paper, and it is a nice thing. That's the thing I like with Pilot nibs, and I like also in Sailor nibs, because they are nibs, you can feel the paper. They make noise, but they are not scratchy. Other reason to hear some noise is because this is a fine Japanese nib, and Japanese nibs, fine nibs, are usually equivalent to an extra fine European nib, so it's understandable that it makes more noise. About the wetness, because it is a fine nib, it's not super wet, but it delivers the right amount of ink for this kind of nib, so very happy with this. About line variation, okay, it is a gold nib, but don't expect any. You can see maybe some, but we are forcing the nib really hard, and it's not what this nib was meant for. This is just a pen to write where... This is the pen you have to use when you think of using a ballpoint. You think, ah, this is the situation to have to use a ballpoint pen because it's easier to use. Then you can use this pen. Very nice. I really recommend this pen. It's a great choice. More about it. No line variation, as I showed you, or very little. A smooth nib with a little feedback. You can have reverse writing, but this is the normal, this is the reverse. Not real big difference, but maybe this is a little finer. And this is a really good nib, because it is a fine nib, equivalent to an extra fine. And it has Pilot cartridges that have some ink capacity. It is great because it lasts for a very long time. This is a great pen. This is the pen that I usually like to use when I have to travel by plane in work situations. It's the kind of pen that never fails to me. And that's it. This is how the pen works. This is not a pen for everybody because, as I told you, it has this clip between your nibs, your fingers, but I really love them and I find the carbonesque finish really beautiful. So, thank you for watching the video. Please subscribe our YouTube channel and come back for more content like this. See you next time. Bye.